My name is Cass and welcome to my Minecraft custom map review. Today we are looking at the custom map, the Cubeception, created by Geminos and Pycia 997. The version I used was 1.1. Story. After a catastrophic event, the world is destroyed, and humankind is forced to live in the only shelter left, the cube. One day you wake up in your prison cell and see that some of the buildings in the cube are destroyed and abandoned, and so begins your journey to find a way out of the cube, guided by a person you don't really know. The atmosphere and the story is very good. The different notes are well written and help you feel completely immersed. On the other hand, the immersion is sometimes sadly broken because of the frequency of the more story-related notes. They are sometimes just too scattered. Creativity. This map is exceptionally creative and beautiful. All of the buildings in the cube are well crafted and feel real. The different parts of the city you will see will make you believe that people could have really lived there. Variety. The only things you really have to do in this map are searching for the right way and then jump to it, which can get a bit repetitive. Luckily, the jumping puzzles are really diverse and are well built into their surroundings. Most of them don't feel forced or out of place. Difficulty. This map is built on peaceful, so only jumping puzzles can drive you insane and or to your death. The map is of medium difficulty, with some harder jumping bits and some places which can confuse you a bit. Random stuff. Two great features will make your life in this map a bit easier. The first one is a shortcut system that will greatly reduce the time to your former locations in case you have died. The second feature isn't really part of the map. The creators made a little walkthrough that can help you if you get stuck. Conclusion. The Cubeception is a jumping-focused adventure map. The story is really good and well told and will easily carry you through the map. If you aren't a jumping person, the map can get a bit repetitive and the frequency of the notes can break your immersion. But for a person that really likes jumping, this will be a really enjoyable trip. Last but not least, the map takes around 120 minutes to complete. That's about it. I hope that you like my little review, that my German accent isn't that annoying, and most importantly, that I could help you decide if you want to play this map. My name is Cass, and I hopefully see you next time.
Please.